back to my YouTube channel. We're here again for another digital short, and our topic for today is all about the CENOMAR. Okay, are you aware of the CENOMAR or yung tinatawag na Certificate of No Marriage? So a CENOMAR is actually a PSA issued document. So it's the Philippine Statistics Authority of the Philippines that issues it, and doon mo makikita if ang isang tao ay single or not officially, okay? Ibig sabihin, in the records of the Philippine Registry, Civil Registry, and doon mo makikita kung kasal o hindi kasal ang isang tao, okay? So, the CENOMAR, of course, is very important if you are applying for a marriage license, you intend to get married, or nire-require din siya on other application forms, no? If for example, others would be, for example, mag-apply sa ibang bansa or something, and it would require them for that type of document. So, nag-secure din sila ng mga CENOMAR, okay? And sometimes, if there are wrong entries in a person's birth certificate, the CENOMAR of the parents is also required and used, okay? Ano namang ma-expect niyo dun sa CENOMAR if you get it, okay? If na-issuean kayo, well, makikita nyo lang doon na if you are single at wala talaga sa record at all ng any marriage, doon sa marriage indices, ang pangalan mo, ang nakalagay lang po doon ay walang record, okay? So, ibig sabihin, based on the marriage indices of the Philippine Statistics Authority from way, way back up until a specific period from the time that you applied for your CENOMAR, your name does not appear, okay, in the marriage indices. Ibig sabihin, you're not married, okay? That's the best proof of you being single. What if may lumabas doon, okay? What if yung iba, ang experience nila is parang sham wedding, or inisip nila hindi naman totoo or valid yung wedding, pero naipasok pala doon. Others naman, I know of situations na parang parang let's say like a fixed marriage with another person, hindi nila in-expect na totoo pala or naipasok doon, naipasok yung sa civil registry yung marriage marriage contract nila, so talagang papasok sa marriage indices yun, no? So kapag ganyan, hindi po kayo legally free to marry if you have a record sa CENOMAR, okay? Doon mo rin makikita sa CENOMAR if there are bigamous marriages, let's say second, third, and so on marriages of a person. It does happen. I don't know how they do it or what happens or anong kaguluhan or anong history sa isang person kung bakit nangyari yun. But it happens that a person has several marriages appearing in the CENOMAR, and that is a proof that there has been a bigamous marriage, and yung subsequent marriages would be considered void, but you have to petition the court to nullify it based on being a bigamous marriage. So I hope you learned something again. When you're securing your CENOMAR, make sure that you check it right. Tignan nyo agad, single ka ba or not? Baka ma-surprise ko it with what you'll see. But it's best to check your status dun sa marriage indices when you get your CENOMAR. And that's it. I hope you learned something new today from my channel. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye!